Welcome students. I welcome you to the new discussion on extravascular administration. Well, as you know, out of the various routes of administration, we broadly classify our discussions or limit our discussions to IV, that is intravenous, as well as extravascular administration. So today our discussion will be based on the kinetics, that is the basics about the extravascular administration, followed by its pharmacokinetics. So let us start the discussion. Okay, so myself, HASSAN'S, will discuss in details about the extravascular administration. Hope so, you know what is an extravascular administration. Extra means other than vascular, the vascular route, that is the blood vessels. So it generally implies to all the routes of administration other than the vascular route. Hope you understand. Other than the vascular route. Now, when I am saying other than the vascular route, it implies it may be ocular, it may be nasal, it may be oral, it may be vaginal, it may be anal, it may be any of the routes through which you can administer a drug. But basically, as the majority of our extravascular administration occurs through the oral route, so we'll restrict our discussion within the oral route of administration. So when I'm going to discuss about the extravascular route, that means we are discussing about the oral route of administration. Please keep this thing in mind. So when we are discussing regarding the process, so previously I have discussed that obviously all the pharmacokinetic process which occurs in our body follows first order, unless so far it is limited process like enzymatic process where receptors are there, where you will be having a restriction of the number of the binding sites, where there is a chance of saturation. Irrespective of that, it is an first order kinetics. So in this case, as I'm saying, the process involves two first order rate kinetics process. Till now you have came across only one rate kinetics process, that is the elimination rate kinetics. In IV bolus or IV infusion, the major rate kinetic, that is the first order rate kinetic process which is involved, is elimination rate constant. Whereas in the extravascular route, there is an additional rate kinetics which is called as absorption rate kinetics. Like your elimination rate kinetics, your absorption rate kinetics also follows a first order rate kinetics. So please keep this thing in mind. There are two rate kinetics process. One is your absorption rate kinetics, another is your elimination rate kinetics, and both follows the first order rate process. Now, when I am going to discuss about the Ka, that I am saying absorption rate kinetics, and K capital E, that is your elimination rate kinetics, which one is faster? That you have to understand. That will go further in details. So here you can see, as I mentioned, Ka, that is absorption rate kinetics, is much faster than Ke, that is the elimination rate kinetics. There are some incidents when this Ka is slower than Ke. There are some cases where Ka is slower than Ke. In those cases, we generally call it as the flip-flop of KAKE. This is also known as flip-flop of KAKE. That is, generally the elimination is slower, absorption is faster, but in certain cases absorption will be slower and elimination will be faster. So this case is called as flip-flop kinetic process. Generally, what happens, you have to remember, we'll discuss later in details about this, but you have to remember that there are a lot of processes like where we restrict the release rate of the drug. The absorption rate gets slower. So when the absorption rate gets slower, obviously it results in the flip-flop kinetics. Then the another thing which I thought of saying, that most of the equations what you have seen till now were mono exponential. Example, C equals to C naught e to the power minus KET. So e to the power minus KET, there is only one exponential form. That is e to the power something. We are saying this as a exponential form. There is only one. That is KE. That you have seen in IV bolus as well as in the IV infusion also. But in the case of what you call absorption rate kinetics, you will find both e to the power KAT as well as e to the power KET. Both will be in the exponential form. As I said you, both the processes follows a first order rate kinetics. So that's the reason you have to keep this thing in mind. Again, when I was I thought of discussing this extra point, generally we'll find that our discussions will be restricted to the first order process, but there are some special cases. Within the extravascular route of administration, just now I told you, you have lot of drug deliveries where the release is slowed or the release is controlled. Example, SR tablets, sustained release tablets, or the osmotic pump, osmotic tablets, whatever you're using, mucoadhesive tablets, sustained release, controlled release. So all these types of drug delivery generally results in a zero order drug release. It results in zero order drug release. So when there is a zero order drug release, so rating process generally will not be a first order, so it will be a zero order, and then it will reach to the systemic circulation. After it reaches to the systemic circulation, then we have something called as the elimination rate kinetics, that is a KE. So that is a first order. So this is somewhat similar, as I mentioned over here, the equation for this, in this case, if you are asked that what will happen if your drug release follows a zero order instead of the conventional drug delivery through oral route where it follows first order. The equation will be almost similar to that of your IV infusion. Just keep this thing in mind. Okay? Okay, let us now go for the discussion part. This is the normal, you can say this is the normal plasma drug concentration curve of extravascular route of administration. You can see, as in the case of IV, initially we have 100% viability followed by elimination, but in this case we'll be having zero viability initially. As the time goes on, your absorption rate increases and it reaches to the maximum, then it goes down and finally elimination occurs. So this is how the absorption followed by elimination takes place when you go for an extravascular route of administration. Obviously, there are few things which you have to consider. The total curve, this is the total curve of oral route of administration, which is broadly classified into three phases. Actually, it is four phases. One phase is, I will just add up just now. So there are three phases mainly. One we call it as absorption phase. One we call it as post-absorption phase. Another we call it as the elimination phase. there is another one which I am saying, which is not mentioned over here, is the fourth one, where this is called as the plateau phase, which is denoted by Cmax and Tmax. Hope so you know it. So this is the plateau phase, which is denoted by Cmax and Tmax. Now, what do you mean by absorption phase? Generally, in the absorption phase, we can see when the drug initially starts to undergo absorption process, what happens is, your rate of absorption starts to increase from the zero. So in the zero time, there is no elimination. So elimination is zero. Absorption starts. So initially, if you see, the absorption goes in a first order kinetics. Then your elimination switches on and it starts to bend. Your curve starts to bend. That is, the rate of absorption and the rate of elimination starts to undergo equilibrium process. That is, slowly, 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 your absorption rate is decreasing and the elimination rate is increasing. It starts to bend the curve. It reaches over here. What we call it as the plateau phase. And upon reaching to the plateau phase, the rate of absorption is equal to the rate of elimination. So the plateau phase, as you can see, the rate of absorption is equal to the rate of elimination. Thereafter, what happens? It starts to get reduced much lower. The absorption rate reduces and the elimination rate increases. So it bends the curve downwards towards the elimination process. So it is a rate of process and it bends down. This part is called as post-absorption phase. You can see it is not exactly a continuous curve. The post-absorption phase continues up to somewhere over here, right? You can see it. I am just marking with my cursor up to here. You can see there is a notch. So after this, your absorption stops. Your absorption stops and the remaining which continues for your 7 to 8 half-lives, you know, it is your elimination phase. So this is the thing you have to remember when you are considering the extravascular route of administration. I repeat, absorption phase, the rate of absorption is greater than the rate of elimination. The plateau phase, that is the Cmax point, the rate of absorption is equal to the rate of elimination. Post-absorption phase, the rate of absorption is lower than the rate of elimination. And the elimination phase, there is a total absence of the absorption phase. So let us go for the next slide. So this is the schematic diagram of one compartment open model extravascular unchanged drug in the plasma. So through extravascular vein we are administering, so it is very clear. So there is a rate-in process. XA is the amount of the drug which is undergoing the absorption. And it is showing X as the amount of the drug which is present in the systemic circulation at the time T, which is further undergoing an instantaneous elimination process by K. So since it is being taken from a book, specifically I like to mention that it is being taken from Basic Pharmacokinetics by John Baker. So there they are mentioned as K. So I will be in my discussions you will be getting as KE. So I'm just mentioning over here. So that is nothing but your elimination rate constant. And XU is the amount of the drug that is coming out in the in as a form of urine. So you have to remember this. Then, so this is the block diagram. Now, here is something called as XA. That is the amount of the drug that is undergoing absorption. But if you remember, in IV bolus, X naught is generally being used as equivalent to the dose of the drug. Why are we using this XA? This is the next part of our discussion. XA is not equal to X naught, that is the dose. XA, that is the amount of the drug undergoing absorption, is not equal to the dose of the drug. So why I am saying it so? Because X naught, that is the dose of the drug, undergoes a lot of different degradation within your GI lumen. That's what that may be due to pre-systemic metabolism, or it may be due to a bacterial degradation or loss by some other enzymatic degradation process. In lot of ways, there is some loss of the drug when we are giving extravascularly. So the dose which is being administered is not undergoing absorption. So that is why XA is not equal to X naught. Rather, we can say XA equals to FX naught, where F is the fraction of the total drug dose which is absorbed. KA, next, KA plays a very important role in extravascular pharmacokinetics. Of course, it is a very judgmental part, or you can say a parameter, pharmacokinetic parameter, which is very essential for your extravascular route of administration. I told you beforehand, we will be having an instance when KA will be less than KE, that I told it as a flip-flop. There may be an instance when KA is equal to KE. That is an instance what you get it as Cmax point. So what is the consideration that you have to know? So generally, there are various methods of determining the Ka. This is a very important point you have to remember, and we have to undergo the derivation. That is, there are two ways of determining Ka. Number one, we call it as Wagner-Nelson method. So sorry, number one, what they are saying it over here is graphical method or method of residual, and second one, non-graphical method or Wagner-Nelson method. So we have to know in details what is there. We'll successively know in the later classes. So next, what are the parameters which will come across? Most few of the parameters, hope so you know it. It's similar. Like elimination rate constant, we have done it beforehand. We know what is elimination rate constant. We know what is AUC, that is area under curve or bioavailability. We also know the volume of distribution. Also, there is other parameters like clearance, T half. These are the parameters which we know or we have already discussed. But in the next, this session of discussion regarding exclusively for extravascular, we have some extra parameters. We have to know what is Ka. It is the rate at which the drug undergoes absorption across the GI lumen. So that is called as the absorption rate constant. Same unit, hour inverse or time inverse. Cmax, it is the maximum concentration achieved by a drug. And the time required to achieve is called as Tmax. So these are the three parameters which we have to know in details. So in the next discussions, we exclusively will go into the mathematical derivations and establishment of the equations of all which is enlisted below, followed by understanding the method of residual and Wagner-Nelson method, which is very important as per as your examination point of view. Hope so you understand the concepts clearly, and we'll be having a small test session also after this discussion. You'll be getting the test questions very soon, and if you have any kind of doubts, you can ask me, you can mail me off. So no problem if you have any kind of doubts. I always welcome you to put it in the YouTube channel. If you are not a